hailing from parts unknown, Mark Greenblood! And his opponent, hailing from Detroit, Michigan, the Illusionist, Derek 120!
And welcome back to the West Coast Wrestling Connection, Blake Chadwick alongside Brian Zane. Brian, what a way for you to be reintroduced here to the WCWC, a big upset in our opening contest.
You know, time makes the best out of all of us. I can't believe how much this company has just evolved and grown so much since I've been here last time, with brand new stars making brand new opportunities. And here we have the mysterious Jerick 120. Now, this guy, he says, an illusionist, a magician. I don't know what to make of this guy. He seems kind of like a big question mark to me.
And we'll certainly get to Jerick in a second here. But of course, Brian, you go back. We just saw the grappler was on the phone. Was he talking to Morty Lipschitz? What was the grappler up to on the phone a few minutes ago?
Saying something about take care of it, you know, I pay you to do this. Well, who's he talking about? Who's he paying? Who's taking care of what? I guess the only people who know that for sure is the grappler and whoever's on the other end of that phone call.
You could certainly go back in the past and see the bounties that the grappler along with the rest of the Wrecking Crew have laid out. So there's certainly a precedent there for that to possibly come into play. The bell sounds. We are underway here. Mark Greenblood in that mask taking on the debuting Jerick 120, the magic man from Detroit.
Is he wearing a hoodie?
We don't know a whole lot about Jerick, other than the fact that he's a magician from Detroit. He's been trained by Brian Kendrick, Booker T, Nigel McGuinness, Roddy Piper. He's had a lot of big-time names hands-on with him, but we don't know a whole lot about him otherwise.
I think he likes to keep it that way. I think it's mysterious. I mean, I even asked him. I talked to him today. I asked him, what's the 120 mean in your nickname?
Oh!
He refused to tell me. He said that, you know, it's a magic trick in and of itself. And again, it goes over my head what he's talking about. But, you know, I guess the part of the mystique is what makes him so effective in the ring.
Impressive cutter there by Jerick once again. A man who is making his WCWC debut. And you have to wonder what he has up his proverbial sleeve here, Brian.
Yes, well, if he were wearing the coat in the ring, he would have something up his sleeve, but here he's just got the elbow pads. I was talking to him, and he says that he is now residing in Marina Del Rey, California, originally from Detroit. And, you know, the SoCal folks, there's this perception that people from SoCal are, you know, they're not really genuine people. And so I wonder, when I hear Jerick talk, he seems like such a nice guy, but there's a part of me that wonders, there's something off about his vibe.
You almost wonder, is there an ulterior motive when it comes to Jerick 120? Leto press, and referee Sparky Ballard says it's only two. But you have to wonder, someone that has that magician's background could be that master manipulator. You don't really know what they're up to at all times.
When you're a magician, part of your whole job description is to manipulate people's frames of thought and their psyche. And I think, from my limited experience talking to him, it seems that he is good at that.
He's got him up there for a gut wrench. Nice job by Greenblood. There's a backslide. Huge upset could be on its way. Only a two count right there, but Jerick now inside cradle. Wait a minute. Reversed once again by Greenblood.
Greenblood is surprisingly competent in this matchup here.
He's got him up, fireman's carry. Jerick slips behind him.
You stopped him.
He looks like he finds a coin behind his ear. Hey, where did that come from?
Hey, you can't have a magician without magic tricks. Wait, what's he doing now?
Looks like he's going to call me. Oh, no.
Oh, my God. Whoa. He's out. Oh,
he knocks him right out there. Two. Three,
whoa.
And just like that, Jerick 120 picks up the win.
Jerick 120!
Well, there you go. I mean, Jerick makes an impressive impact in his debut here in the WCWC. I don't think I've ever seen, God, not since Fantasio have I seen someone win a match with a magic trick, but we've seen it here tonight, only in the WCWC.
A spellbinding victory, if you will.
There you go.
For Jerick 120, unbelievable turn of events right there. Pulls that coin out from right behind Greenblood's ear, then knocks him out with one punch. I guess he's woken him up because Greenblood's out of the ring, but Jerick 120 picks up a huge win in his WCWC debut.
Unbelievable. And, you know, the back of his truck say disturb reality. That's exactly what happened.
Brian, I'm not trying to interrupt you here, but I'm getting word from the back that something has just gone down. There is some sort of emergency in the back. I'm not.